440 million years ago, 85% of life was wiped from Earth in a mass extinction. And that was just the first one we know of. We humans are living through and causing the sixth. So should we be seriously worried, or is mass extinction actually normal in the context of the history of time? Ask anyone on the street whether we should protect endangered species and they'll probably say, yeah, for sure. Whether it's orangutans under threat from palm oil, whales killed in the name of bogus science, or polar bears drowning in rising seas, keeping flora and fauna from going extinct is undeniably a good thing, right? To answer that question, I have a question for you. Of all the life that has ever existed on the face of this planet, how much of it has gone extinct? 20%? 40? 60? 85? Here's the thing, more than 99% of species that have ever lived have gone extinct. 99.
Extinction is as normal as death.
The world collectively spends billions of dollars trying to keep species alive. And while charismatic megafauna like polar bears, orangutans, and whales get a lot of attention, a lot of extinctions go unnoticed.
Most of the extinctions that have happened since we've been around are actually parasites.
So how significant is it to be in the sixth mass extinction? Let's look at the current rate, the reasons, and the impacts of it. First, the rate. About 440 million years ago, 85% of species were wiped out. Life bounced back, and then 66 million years later, another 75% of species died. 124 million years on, 95% of life gone. Another 50 million years, and another 80% bit the dust. The most famous mass extinction was 65 million years ago, when roughly 76% of life died out. I'm talking about the dinosaurs, which were wiped out by an asteroid.
That blotted out the sun and vaporized species probably for thousands of kilometers.
Professor Corey Bradshaw, an ecologist from Flinders Uni, says mass extinction is defined as at least 75% of species being wiped out across a time span of 2 to 3 million years, which sounds like ages, but really is no time at all in the context of Earth's 4.5 billion years. And he says extinction also opens up opportunities for other species to evolve, replacing the ones that became extinct. Life, rising from the ashes like a phoenix. Judging from the fossil record, scientists think we humans have sped up the extinction rate by anywhere from 10 to 10,000 times, which means we're losing them too quickly for new species to evolve at the same rate. There are no longer enough phoenixes rising from the extinction ashes.
We potentially will be losing the equivalent of a mass extinction event in hundreds of years.
The reason for that? You can probably guess. Habitat loss is the principal driver of extinction and endangerment. Half of the Earth's land has been bulldozed just to feed us.
When you add the heating to that already vastly degraded system, it's 10 times the effect. So it's like, it's, you know, you've hit the knockout punch.
And the impacts are severe. Each species that's knocked out makes it more likely that the species around it will also die out.
If we continue on our path, there is going to be massive, massive ecosystem collapse, and life as we know it just, you know, won't be able to continue.
There isn't a scientist I know in my field that isn't affected psychologically by this.
The bottom line is this. We humans are causing an extinction event that only asteroids and ice ages can match. We can't reverse that, but we can lessen the impact. Globally, we spend about $33 billion a year on conservation, which is nothing compared to the trillions that countries will spend recovering from COVID-19. So should we all be doing more to try and slow down the extinction rate and save species? Absolutely. And should we be anxious about doing that? Absolutely.
Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.